I wouldn't know you if there wasn't, I came out to the Restaurant Association meeting out at Reef Beverage, and that's when I heard y'all speak about what your goals, what your feelings are about where we live. And I was sold on you right then. And then Sonia got us together, and you marketed your campaign with us, and thank you for that. And then my daughter, I love her with all my heart, and she came from a really bad situation where domestic abuse caused her mouth, and Vicki wanted to see, Vicki's a fixer, she wanted to say,
yes, Vicki's a fixer,
she said,
she's always been,
let me get a hold of this, but it was on a Sunday. She said, I'll get him when he gets out of church. And that meant so much. There's just no way to thank you for building up her confidence again. For those of you who don't know, we lost a baby, and we were supposed to do this on August 21st. So you're our August random act of kindness, belatedly. And you were nominated by my daughter, and she said, thank you for everything you do for the community, including myself. You made me smile with confidence again. And then me, I went to the media conference this morning in Six.
And that's really pretty cool.
Oh, yeah.
That's going to be
really awesome. Anyway, it's been such an honor to know you and be on your journey in public service. You have a huge heart of service, and you've been in our hearts for us to honor you just for your contributions in time for our city. But God put it on our hearts to let you know specifically how much your gift of your time, talent, and staff mean to us. Patricia hasn't been able to have a big smile now for over 2 years. 2 years of grinning with her mouth shut. When my aunt died, people were coming up to her and wanting to talk to her, and she smiled like that, and it was a heartbreaker. Thank you for leading prayers at our networking client breakfast. What a humble heart. Good stewards of quality of life can be found in those who give the most of themselves without striving for self-recognition or expectations or givebacks. Aren't we blessed in Amarillo and the surrounding area for having so many with these characteristics? Dr. Eddie, this is you. Your random act of kindness include leading by integrity and grace, sharing your shape, spiritual gifts, your heart, your abilities, your personality and experience without fail, lending a sympathetic ear and truly listening, seeking others who have needs and connecting them to resources. Thank you. You are such an example of love. So when you have one of those days, I hope we can cause one, please look at this little honor and know that you are prayed for out loud daily. You are so very much appreciated. You know that God loves you so much and how he uses you in his ministry. You are so loved. Thank you for your heart of service, love always. Then from Vicki Brooks, isn't she pretty? Yes, you are the best, most adored, and generous dentist in the world, love Vicki. Congratulations from Shelley Thompson of Edible Arrangements. She sponsors this. And she was really having a bad day a while ago, but getting to do these makes her have a better day.
Well, thank you.
For that, she is.
Thank you.
And then, Roger, if you take it to the grocery store, Tina, you'll probably inherit this. If you take it to the grocery store, then you save a duck or something because those plastic things fly. I write mine a duck. And this is my prescription for you from General Office Supply.
Uh-huh.
Chill pills.
Chocolate.
And the instructions are really cool. And this is from Aardvark Automotive. And
thank you.
I hope nobody has a peanut allergy. But anyway, this is from Texas Roadhouse. And then I've got something really special for you here.
Okay.
Do
you want me to hold that bag for you?
No, I got it. Okay. Thank you. And you're going to think it's broken, but it's not. it fits one part fits into the other, and it's an angel. God owns the wrong part, you know, and angels are symbols.
So it goes like.
Uh-huh.
Oh, very cool.
She kind of looks.